In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the remote camera feature in the Stop Motion Studio Pro app. This allows you to connect an external camera such as a high-quality DSLR camera or even another phone. The reason you may want to do this is if you are like me and you bump your camera around when you're taking the photos for your stop motion. If you have the remote camera function working, then you don't even need to touch the camera because you can control all of the settings from another device. Now you'll be glad to know that this useful feature works on all versions and devices of the Stop Motion Studio app. But for this video, I'm going to be using an iPhone, iPad, and MacBook. For this first part, I'm going to show you how to connect a phone to another device, and after that, I will show you how to do it with a DSLR camera. So for this first example, say you want to connect a phone to a tablet. I think this is the best combination because you can use the phone as the camera since it's smaller and easier to work with for better angles, while the tablet can be like the control center with the bigger screen. To do this, you need to have Stop Motion Studio Pro on the tablet, and on the phone, you need to have a different app called the Remote Camera app. Stop Motion Studio Pro is about $5, as you probably know already. However, the Remote Camera app is free. Okay, now to connect the two devices, open up the Remote Camera app on the phone. When you first open it, you will need to click OK on these prompts so that the app will work properly. The first one is just telling the device to use the built-in camera, and the other asks to connect to a local network. You need to make sure that the phone and tablet are both on the same Wi-Fi network, or else the feature will not work at all. Once the app opens up to look like this, put it to the side for a second and move over to the tablet. Open up Stop Motion Studio Pro and click on a project. By default, it will start using the camera on the iPad. In order to use the remote camera, you need to click on this button and then on the camera icon. Now, if your tablet is on the same Wi-Fi as the phone, then it will appear here, and you just need to select it. You can control all the camera functions such as focus and shutter speed from your tablet. By the way, this works with any combination of devices. You could have it the other way around, or even use a laptop instead of the iPad. Okay, now for the second part. I'm going to show you how to connect a high-end DSLR camera to the Stop Motion Studio Pro app. Stop Motion Studio supports so many cameras, as you can see from this list. I have left a link in the description to the page if you want to check if your camera is compatible. To connect the camera, you're going to need a USB cable to link the camera to the laptop. For this example, I'm using the Canon EOS T6i. Unfortunately, you cannot connect a DSLR camera like this to a phone or tablet as of now. However, this may change in the future. Once you have the camera connected, open up the Stop Motion Studio app on your computer. Next, turn your camera on, and if everything is correct, you should see the name of your camera appear next to the remote camera setting. If you do not see this immediately, then you may need to still wait about 30 seconds for your computer to recognize your camera. However, if still nothing happens, check to see if you have a memory card inside the camera. And if the camera still doesn't appear in the app, then there is probably a setting on your camera that's preventing a connection through the USB cable. I had this issue when I first tried this, and it took me a long time to figure out what the problem was. For most Canon DSLR cameras, there is a Wi-Fi function, and when this is turned on, the camera refuses to send data over the USB cable. So if this is turned on, go into your camera's setting and disable it. That should fix the issue, and then your camera will appear in the app. Click on it and you will see a live view from the lens. Like with the phone and tablet, you can control all the camera settings from the app, so you don't even need to touch it. If you found this tutorial helpful, leave a like and a comment down below to let me know. Also, check out these Stop Motion Studio tutorials on the screen now. I highly recommend watching them if you want to save time learning how to use this app.